way when the Supreme Court held that you have no privacy interest in your bank records. Someone tried to argue that the personal checks that he had written to the bank were his financial records, and therefore the government couldn't simply subpoena them from the bank because he had a Fourth Amendment interest in them. They needed a warrant based on probable cause. And the Supreme Court said, sorry, no go, you're out of luck. These aren't your records. They are the records that you have voluntarily disclosed to a third party, and therefore you have no privacy interest. The Supreme Court extended that rationale to the phone numbers you dial in a case called Smith v. Maryland. So if you type in a phone number, right, or if you call a phone number or someone calls you, the Supreme Court has said you have no privacy interest in that. If this doctrine is carried to its extreme, that means that in the digital era, we will have no privacy in anything anymore, because if you use Gmail or Yahoo for your email, it is all stored by a third-party company, all of your location data is stored by a third-party company. I think courts looking at the extreme consequences of that argument push back on it. So for example, one federal appeals court has ruled, for example, that you have a privacy interest in the content of your email, even though a third party has access to it. But this is the government's primary argument about location information as well. You know, you chose to carry a cell phone. I remember reading one government brief in particular in which they said that anyone who doesn't want to be tracked, there's a simple solution for those people. They can leave their cell phones at home, right? You sort of like wonder what world the government anticipates that we will inhabit if we don't want to be subjected to 24-hour tracking. But this is one of the major arguments.